time that never was cleansed. Comrades, this is the kind of faith that is going to see victory in the Grenadines in this general election scheduled for December 13th. And I want to ensure you that the message of this campaign has been embraced by all, by young and by old. I was doing a presentation to some primary school students recently, one of the schools on the mainland. Yep. And after I finished with the presentation to the class, and I was leaving the class, the young man shouted out so that I could hear, "We're not on back." And the entire class went into an uproar, and the students start shouting, and the students start chanting. And we recognize that it's not only the individuals who will vote in this election that have owned the campaign. Students in primary school, students in primary school, and students in preschool, and even before that, are owning the campaign as well. And we move to deliver victory to them. We move to deliver victory to all those who have fought before and who want us to continue that fight and to finish that fight. Comrades, we have to fight on. We have to always remember what we've shared in this message before. We have to remember where there's a will, there's a way. So let us fight on together. Here as up. Where there's a will, there's a way, comrades. And we're going to find a way to bring victory in this election and to bring victory to this constituency, comrades. We want the Unity Labour Party administration for a third term. And as we fight on, I don't want us to believe in our individual strength. I want us to believe in our collective strength. I don't want us to believe in what we could do as one person. I want us to believe in what we could do as an army that is marching forward together. An army that is united. An army of the Unity Labour Party, comrades. We have a lot to defend, because even as we fight a political campaign right now to be returned to government, we've been fighting for you in government for the past 10 years. We fight this campaign now so that we can fight for you again in another 5 years and more. Comrades, without victory in this election, there is no survival for what the Labour Party has stood for. The Labour Party has stood for progressive principles. The Labour Party has taken steps to improve the conditions of Vincentians. And I think that we're going to fight. We're going to show that we are a grateful people. We're going to show that the benefits of this government have come to the people of St. Vincent and the Grenadines. And that is why the campaign is going to be led by the people of St. Vincent and the Grenadines. Comrades, sometimes in this campaign, I think that the politicians might as well take a back and allow you to move forward, and allow you to carry the message, and allow you to deliver victory. And one thing that we're going to do to make sure that we get that victory is go early to the polls on December 13th. Go early in our numbers. Go early and carry our neighbors. Go early and carry our friends. Go early and make sure we give a ride to an individual who might not have a ride and vote for the Unity Labour Party administration, comrades. We're going to fight on, as Razam says, and we're going to bring victory here, and we're going to bring victory to this administration for a third term, comrades. As I leave, let's reflect on those words of Razam. We have to fight on, comrades. We have to remember that where there's a will, there's a way. We have to remember that we have to make way for the upcoming generation this time. This is the time for the Northern Grenadines. This is the time for the Southern Grenadines. And this is the time for constituencies throughout St. Vincent and the Grenadines to show new confidence, to show continuing confidence in the Unity Labour Party administration. Politics is about the future, and your future is in safe hands with the Unity Labour Party. Comrades, good night. It was a pleasure. I'm gonna They have become so far from the reality that they fail to recognize that the no campaign that they are pushing, that the no that they are seen, is a no against them, is a no against their brothers, it's a no against the same king that they are telling you to vote for. The no to the front and the key to the back.
Does the party who
what or where is the sense in that?
Do they always provide?
Are these people serious?
What?
Are they ready to govern?
It is still a problem.
Still a problem.
Are they ready to manage? Again,
but it's who you are.
10 years.
No.
Tell us, Mr. Grenadines.
No matter what.
Tell us, Mr. Nutty Grenadines. What have you done for Big Win?
But I've just
tell us, Mr. Nutty Grenadines. You want to win it again? Tell us what are your intentions for Nutty Grenadines. Tell us your plans. How you intend to develop Nutty Grenadines. You voted against the education revolution.
I'm sorry,
people
like, okay,
remember that.
Time, I do 6 months, say 6 months.
Remember that he voted no.
Most people, you know.
Against the education revolution.
A lot of people.
In other words, your son must stay in seniors. One of their very own, a big educator, said. One of their very own. Comparing the education revolution with the senior level in cricket at their time. This man announced that
Colorado?
A senior student then under the NDP was more qualified and more experienced than you today who have benefited from the education revolution. Are these people serious?
No. Up at our villa, the
are they ready to lead a government?
Yellow party as well.
They seem to think that we are the jokers.
And I was like, whoa.
We have the aces. The joke is on them.
No, I'm not big.
This time, not in where it is, it's Labour Man.
We're
going to show them that no one man ruled this rock.
And I couldn't hear.
We're going to show them that we come in this time. They ought to take money.
Understand what they say.
They ought to take money. Collectively as looks it. You in your house, you, your neighbor, your nene, your tante, your uncle, your son, your daughter, all are we vote a labor. I'm going to call a man. One from here again.
Live in London, England?
This gentleman, time ago,
what do you do here in Bethlehem?
Run for this constituency.
Well, I've just returned to live.
Yeah.
This gentleman won this constituency.
Oh, nice.
Not doing anything.
And this gentleman was treated unfairly.
It was a pleasure.
I hate to say this, but most women that I met, like,
because
you,
another gentleman
like,
fought.
I'm a housewife.
He could have gone on the mainland and run and win.
That's what they say to me.
When that did not happen,
in England,
he came back here.
Since I was 17.
And he said to the gentleman who was elected from here.
Until I was 16.
All right, you come back. Give it back.
During my winter time.
That gentleman is going to talk to you. That gentleman represented you.
so.
As an ambassador for many years.
6 months here.
Yeah.
Tonight, I am pleased.
7 grandchildren.
And I'm happy to invite Ambassador Cosmos Kosia to address you.
To go.
Please welcome him.
Take care. You too. And take care. Thank you.
Yeah, you should.
Honestly,
what's that?
I should really be a reporter.
No.
Yeah.